One of the unique features of our quad LED assembly is the ability to wire the assembly through the back, through these here wiring holes. To do that, we recommend that you use 28 gauge stranded wire. Stranded wire because it's less likely to break after you get it soldered. You can use 26 gauge wire, but it's a little bit harder to do because you can't pre-tin the wire before you put it through the hole, so it's a little harder to solder in the front. But I'm going to demonstrate how to do this using 28 gauge wire. To begin, you need to strip the end of the wire. We want to tin the wire. Just makes it a lot easier to solder into the base. Make sure your tip is nice and clean. And solder the wire up. You want a nice thin coating. And I'm going to trim this back a little bit. There you go. So nicely tinned. Now I'm going to put this wire into hole number one here, which is the cathode for LED number one. So, and we'll just bring that around and set it flat. Then we want to apply a little bit of flux. Just makes it a little easier to solder. Make sure your tip is nice and clean. Apply the tip to the wire and to the pad. Heat a bit, apply your solder, and release. Doesn't take much, very quick. We got a nice solder joint there. Now I'm going to trim off the end of your wire like so. So we got a nice clean connection. Come out the back. Let's carry on. We'll do the red. Okay, now this one we want to put through pad number two, which is the middle one, this one here, for LED number one. And that's the anode, so we're going to use the red wire for that. Shove that through, and just kind of push it down flat. Again, apply a little bit of flux. Clean your iron, and tin your tip. Put your iron just on the wire and on the pad and tin it, just like that. Okay. And trim off the wire, and that one's done. Nice clean, coming out the back nice and straight. So we'll just carry on and we'll do the rest the same way. Okay, I've soldered in the rest of the wires. And you can see that there's a little bit of flux left over here, but this can be rinsed off with hot water. It's safe to spray on hot water on these assemblies to clean them. You see the wires coming out through the back, and it's ready to be mounted onto your heatsink and powered on.